Welcome back to some Fortnite, everybody. Today is a how to win video, so we're gonna go in depth while we're playing and try to make it a little easier for you guys to improve your game and also win some if you're struggling. The game overall, I try to go through everything that I'm doing, but I'm gonna focus a lot on the late game because that seems to be a big question that pops up. How do I win the late game? How do I do better in the mid to late game? I'm not sure what to do in certain situations. So yeah, let's get into it. I'm gonna head to Anarchy. It's kind of a slower start. Usually you can get like maybe 2-3 kills, but it's an easy setup, you know? It's an easy setup. That's why I want to head here. I personally like going long barn. Don't go big barn. Big barn's bad. I should mention that. A lot of people go big barn. There's only one chest if you're lucky. And if you get lucky as well, there might be a shotgun spot in there. But otherwise, you don't have a lot of loot in big barn. Guy landed next to me. I just heard him land. I have a grenade launcher, so I got a really bad gun to start with, unfortunately. There we go. He's got a shotgun. We could push him, but it's a little late. He walked away, so I don't want to chase him down right now. It's better to try to make sure you get everything that you can in your first spawning area. Shotgun is the number one thing you want, though. I might have to be quiet here and sound whore for a second, because I got one dude that landed at Big Barn as well. I watched him land on it. We're going to collect some wood. Always want to collect your wood early game. You're going to need a little bit to build against people. This is probably enough. 100 materials in general is usually pretty solid. We're gonna look and see if he's in here. He is. Quick little kill. He had another shotgun, which is good. Double shotty. We'll put that in the 5 slot, grab the rifle. Ooh, nice, more C4 too, okay. We'll see if he looted back behind Big Barn. I think he did. There's somebody in here. We're gonna jump up on top of it. There we go. Pretty easy kill for us. No one coming. We're just listening right now. We're playing the sound whoring part of the game. If people get close, you can hear them. This guy did not have shield on, so he should have 3 minis, which is awesome. We're gonna leave C4 on the ground here. A lot of C4s, but we have everything we need. We're gonna sit here and chill for a second, make sure everything is reloaded. We got 3 kills so far. There might be more. The guy that came and challenged me, he could have landed at Big Barn, but it's kind of unlikely. We're still gonna collect some materials. If you can along the way, try to collect some materials. You don't need a lot, but little by little, you can accumulate a fair amount. There's the guy we're looking for. We're gonna build up a little bit. He has a scar. He has a better gun than us. So what we're gonna do is get close with our shotgun. He has no shield, so we can just challenge him here. There we go. Pretty easy overall. If somebody has a much better gun than you, and you don't want to waste a lot of materials early game because you just don't have a lot, the best thing you can do is push your advantage. And the advantage that I have in that situation is I have 2 shotguns. Both are very good. I don't know if he has 150 HP, but I do as well, and he hasn't killed me yet. But if I take peak shots against a SCAR with a green AR, I'm probably going to lose that most of the time. Not all the time, but most of the time. Also, something you want to get used to is ending fights quickly. In solos, at least, what tends to happen is you spend too much time doing fights with players or getting into fights with players and not finishing them quickly, which causes you to get shot in the back. Sometimes it's unavoidable. Sometimes it's just bad luck, you know? Like, you shoot and the guy happens to be right next to you at the time you fire. You're like, well, shit. You got to deal with it then. It kind of, you know, it can suck. There's bad luck involved for sure. But you can limit the amount of times you get shot in the back by trying to end fights quickly. That way you're not in a fight while you also get shot in the back at the same time. Alright, there's one other thing. We can check the truck for a chest and we'll check those back houses. Then we can move. Dropped 4 kills. Looks like Circle is going to be pushing Retail and Salty. So these guys are going to be pushing out to about here on the map. That's where a lot of players would be. Also taking into account that the challenges this week are kills inside, what is it? Shifty Shafts. So there are probably players still around here and in Tilted. It's the safe zone, so they're going to stay here anyway. Might be some people down here, but based on where the bus was going, it was like in this direction. That's still kind of a stretch. So there wouldn't be a whole lot of players coming out of farm area. And it's helpful to remember that kind of stuff, because then you can really figure out where people are going to be pushing from. And that will help you in the long run for sure when you're trying to get kills. If you're not going for kills, I understand a lot of people like to play passive, but if you don't do it, what happens is people will just start accumulating so much stuff that you can't really compete against them effectively in the late game. So you don't want to go up against a dude if you have a green AR, like a freaking silenced SMG, and the dude's got rocket launchers, shotgun, SCAR, 999 material in every section, and all the, you know, that's not a fight you can win. There's a guy up on the bridge. We're just going to pretend we don't see him and see if he comes to push us. He might shoot me from this range, but if he does, I'll build. It's okay. We're just going to, yep, there we go. He missed us. It's okay. We're going to hit this tree a little bit. We're going to let him get close. I don't want to take long range fights. He's going to push me and I'll have a height advantage here. The reason I don't want to take long range fights is because in general, I can't really do enough damage now. I mean, I can hit him. This guy might actually die. He's not building. And he didn't have any shield on him. But if they have shield, because of the damage reduction in rifles, I don't want to take a really long range fight with a rifle now. Unless I'm using a scoped AR and or maybe a sniper. Other than that, it's probably not a good choice. You picked up a few people coming out of tomato tent area, which is really weird. First off, they didn't see each other. Second off, I didn't expect a whole lot on the way to Dusty or on the way to this area for kills from retail. Most players are going to be around here. They might be up on the mountain as well. It might be smart for us to get on the mountain before anyone else has a chance to. Unfortunately, if we do that... Oh, more players right here. Just kill them with an SMG. There we go. Unlucky you got a shot off on me, but that happens. Whatever. Pick up all of his minis. So right now, our biggest problem is that we don't have a lot of heals. I can use my minis and get back to 150. I'm probably just going to use one. Never smart to stand in the open while you do that. You should build, but I felt like I'd get it off since it's just one mini. We're going to use one of them, though. We're going to hold the other. We're going to try to maximize the amount of HP we can get out of them just because we're so low on available heals for us. If we had 10 minis, you know, it's probably okay to use another one for 7, but... And that bugs some people. I know I get comments in my videos. It triggers me when he doesn't drink the thing for 150. It's like... Okay, I heard this guy next to me. What's his name? I thought it said Salty Spring Steve. sticking to his guts. Landed Salty. All right. I could stick around Depot. I don't really want to, though. I think my main concern right now is that... Well, gas is pushing. They're going to be on the edge of gas right now, most likely. My main concern is somebody's up on the cliff. Based on that build and the area of the zone... Mount Olympus, or what we call it, Mount Olympus, is, there's one down low, is a really strong place to be. We have 9,900 wood. That's nice, okay. So we saw one on the other side of the mountain. What we're going to try to do is build up here and challenge the players who are up there. I don't want to build too high, too fast, because this will fall entirely if they just shoot the bottom, unless I have something to connect it to the top of the cliff. All right, nobody up here. We're still going to look for the guy that we saw on this side, though. They built a bridge over to that. That's interesting. We might be able to find him on this hill, then. Do I have a jump pad? I don't. Zone is pretty far. We're going to have to take that into account. We have no heals right now. Man, that guy probably just headed out, honestly. We're going to connect it to this cliff, just in case somebody shoots out one side. Man, if somebody had C4 right now... I couldn't be mad about that play. Couldn't even be mad about that play. C4's both sides. I fall and die. That'd be funny. Perfect video material. That's a ballsy push going across a bridge like that. I'm guessing the guy that I saw over here just kept running. I mean, the zone is so far that he doesn't want to get stuck in the zone either. We don't, for sure. We're in a pretty bad spot where if we fight in the gas right now with no heals, we're probably going to die. Unless we kill a player that has a med kit or bandages on him or a jump pad, we're going to struggle. So when you're in a situation like this, you don't want to shoot people in the back unless you know you can kill them. And I mean guarantee that you can kill them. Otherwise, you're going to have a problem. A lot of people make that mistake where they just want to shoot. And I know this happens because I get shot in the back nonstop. Okay? I know this happens. Let's go over. I don't know. I haven't decided. I wanted to go over, but I think going to the city is okay too. People still might be here is the thing, and I don't want to get shot from the top of the buildings while I'm running through the bottom. My idea was build over the top of the hill really quick and then just run behind these buildings. Line of sight at everything. Line of sight all the big buildings anyway. I don't want to fight them right now. If there was a jump pad around again or a med kit, you know, different story. But I'm very low on heals and I don't want to deal with fights in the gas. Where other players, if they got two or three med kits right now, they're going to have a huge advantage on me if they want to take a gas fight or a storm fight. We should say, is that a jump pad? No. Something blue there. I think it's a pistol. We should make it. We should make it here. But you don't want to shoot somebody in the back unless you can guarantee the kill. There's a guy I just saw. It's a spaceman. I'm not sure. So many people use that black astronaut outfit. It glows like no other. Super easy to see. Super easy to see. If you're going for wins and you're still pretty new to the game, that's not one you want to use because everybody's going to see you with that outfit on and they're going to shoot you. So we got one dude up top. I don't have a sniper, so I don't want to challenge that guy. I really don't like this as an ending zone, in honesty. I'm used to it because I get it a lot, but I really don't like it. Ooh, 300 brick. I don't have that. Shit. All right, we got one guy on the ground. I could pick up that hunting rifle and use the hunting rifle against the player, but still not a good option usually. The guy has height advantage with a rocket launcher. This guy that's pushing him is out of his mind. We're gonna oh dude, I don't know if this is a good call. With the amount of heals that we have, this could be a bad thing. Sit on a tree like this is not good either. Well, I think we should go this way. I want to go for that kill really badly because I want his materials and I want his shields, hopefully, if he has them. But because of where this fight is taking place, I just don't think it's going to work out well for me. If I had a scoped AR, I wouldn't mind challenging that player. But I don't have one of those. And even though I have first shot accuracy on my guns, it's still not a lot of damage. All right, there's a shotgun fight going over here. We're going to ignore that guy. We got to ignore him. I don't see how that ends up well in my favor. Nice. Jump pad. That guy, I don't think that was the guy I heard. I'm gonna shoot this just in case. Nope, not that. Well, I'm not wasting anything because what I'm going to do here is drop the egg launcher for the rocket and then pick up the sniper as well. And this is just so I can remain very versatile in what I want to do. Using a rocket like this, we have six. We're going to use this for seven now. It's almost like having double shotgun. So you see a lot of players do this anyway. And then having the sniper gives us the range we need to hit the people super long range up on the mountains if they choose to stay there. We also got a jump pad off that guy, which is hugely helpful. I didn't know that guy got into a fight in the gas. Oh, there's another guy right there. Well, this is not good. I shot him early thinking maybe he'd be weak because he was in a shotgun fight with that guy, but he was not. I could jump pad on him, but I'm going to save the jump pad just in case I got to go up against somebody on a cliff. What we're going to do is just push close. And he's going to jump off, usually. So people play this. And he's down. Alright, let's take the upgrade for the rocket. We're going to leave the impulses. Usually when you build over some people, their first initial reaction is to get off of the ramp. Because then you have a height advantage directly over them, and they can get killed really easily. The correct play, though, for them is to use a flat platform here. And then jump, build a flat platform under them, and then build a ramp off of it off to the right or left-hand side, choosing whichever one they want. But you never want to jump down and give your opponent a super big height advantage. I didn't push the guy unless I knew I could kill him. Again, I'm going to reiterate that. It's a very big mistake on a lot of players' resumes, is that they push people that they should not. You got to be able to end your things quick, especially with gas pushing you late game and the circle getting smaller. Other players are going to be looking to shoot you in the back if they hear shots. And the shots carry the whole circle, so everybody can hear you're fighting. Oh, man. We can use first shot accuracy. This is a bad challenge here. That was just me being greedy. It's a bad challenge because a sniper can be heard 250 meters, so everybody just heard me shoot. I gave away my position, and there was no guarantee that I'd hit the player. But I do know one of the players is up top. There's the other player under him. I'm pretty sure that's the other player. That's, are they both there? Let's take a look on the map right now. It looks like... Okay. It looks like they're both over there. I thought the person on top was not the astronaut fighting. So, my guess is that they're both over there. Paying attention to character models can help you a lot in the late game as well. Just understanding who is where is a vast improvement off of just guessing. You understand? So, I think the person on top of the mountain was a default girl character. And the guy below is an astronaut. I can tell because he's glowing. But, so, I think both players are over there. Which leaves me with this area. In this little hilly area with some trees, the highest point is I guess it's probably over here on me. This guy jumped down as well. Looks like we're going to do something like build too wide here. He jumped down. We're going to block it. No problems at all. There we go. He had a heavy shotgun, so it's a little bit better than our shotguns at range, but we're not trying to shoot him at range with a shotgun. And the second that I realized he didn't have any shield, it's best to just use the AR. So, let's break this really quick. What we're going to do is use his little building. We're not going to make it too easy to get to us. What we're going to do is block that off entirely. And then we're going to use just one portion of it, really. So now we're looking for one more character. We got four jump pads. We don't want to peek too much right now because people could still be up on the hill. And it gives them a free shot if we're like sitting here standing still looking over this way. So we're going to hug the edge and try to block off the line of sight from all the higher points. I have lost a lot of games for doing this and or for not doing this. I'm sorry. That's why I'm saying you got to do it now. So the way to push that guy was build too wide and build. Make sure you're building back far enough that you get over him. There are tricks to go higher really quickly. One is like doing this where you build a ramp and then you realize you're not high enough. You build a flat wall and then ramp again. Something like that. All right, we found the last player. He's over there. We don't have to worry about being up on the cliff now. We can show our back to the cliff. Hit him once. Once he's weak, just pressure him. Always push your advantage if you can, as long as you can do it without your back being too open. This guy is actually a pretty big noob, but either way. We could shotgun, we could do anything at this point, and it'd be fine. There we go. We'll end it. He had a grenade launcher, but his best option, he used a semi-auto sniper. His best option was to push me with a grenade launcher, probably. A semi-auto would have killed me, but a lot of players at the end of the game have 200 HP. Even if you headshot him, not going to kill him. But there you go. There you have it. I hope that was in-depth enough for you guys and explained everything. I hope you enjoyed as well. A little live video for you on how to win, making it a little bit easier. 12 kills, not too bad. We had to walk a long way, so that's actually not bad at all for the amount of distance we had to walk. Let me see here. Distance traveled 4.6 kilometers, yeah. I mean, I landed at Anarchy, ran to Dusty, and then I had to run all the way over to the edge of the map. So, good range traveled for 12 kills. Not bad at all. Without jump pads as well. We didn't have jump pads till the end. Thank you for all the love. If you enjoy these type of videos, feel free to leave a like, subscribe, whatever. If not, it's okay. And I will see you guys next time.